Hello everyone, today I want to address one of my recent mistakes in my videos, which involves using the deprofiler to measure the performance of my functions. First, I would like to express my gratitude to one of my viewers who pointed out where I went wrong. If you're interested, you can check out the video discussing the best way to access a component. However, today's topic is the profiler marker. The profiler marker is a tool you can use to mark the script code visible in the Unity profiler. This tool is valuable because by default the built-in Unity profiler doesn't profile all method calls. Additionally, enabling deep profiling incurs a significant overhead that can drastically slow down your application and distort the results. To use the profiler marker API, I have already written some code and created a simple script with various functions. These functions are executed when we press the F key. The first function is getComponent, which stores the transform of the game object. However, it does 10,000 times to illustrate the impact clearly. I have also included a simple print function, and a raycast, and a translate function that moves the object in the z-axis each time the loop runs. If we want to measure the execution time of each of these functions, we can navigate to the profiler, turn on the deep profiler, and find them in the hierarchy. Here you can see the milliseconds each method takes to run. Now let's return to our script and learn how to use the profiler marker. First, add the profiler library, then define a static read-only profiler marker. With a name that you want to appear in the profiler. There are two ways to use this tool. The first is auto method, which allows you to enclose the functions you want to profile. It's important to note that the auto method cannot be compiled in build. The other method involves using begin to start profiling and end to stop profiling manually. That's it. You can now go to the profiler, disable the deep profiler, and check the update mono behavior to see the code you have created. This will show you how much time it takes to execute all of the functions. But what if you want to see the execution time for each individual function? For that, simply add a few more profiler markers and break down the code accordingly. Now you can see that the profiler provides individual function execution times. Take note of the difference between deep profiling and profiler marker. Deep profiling can introduce a significant overhead, slowing down your application and altering the results. Thank you for watching. I hope this video is helpful to you. If you would like to see more content like this, please subscribe, like, and leave a comment. Have a fantastic day.